Let's discuss one more concept related to calculation of electric flux due to a point charge through a random surface. We know well that if there is a point charge plus Q, it originates a total of Q by epsilon naught electric flux in all of its surrounding uniformly, or we can say in a total solid angle of 4 pi steradians. This flux is distributed. Now say if we are given with a situation like this, that if there is a random shaped vessel of which the mouth is circular, which is of radius r, and from the center of mouth at a depth h, we have placed a charge plus q. And say we are required to find the electric flux due to this plus q from the lateral surface of this vessel except from its mouth. Then we can say the total flux through the lateral surface of this vessel will be this q by epsilon naught minus the flux which will come out from its circular mouth. So we can directly write the flux through the lateral surface of this vessel is, this flux lateral can be written as q by epsilon naught minus flux through the mouth of this random shaped vessel, which is of circle of area pi r square. And in this situation, if we join the location of charge with the circumference of this mouth, it will be a cone with half angle theta. And corresponding to this half angle theta, we find out the solid angles enclosed by the lateral surface of cone at the vertex. Then the solid angle can be written as 2 pi 1 minus cos theta. And from this triangle, we can write the value of cos theta as h by root of h square plus r square. Now in this situation, this flux through the mouth can be written as total flux is q by epsilon naught, which is distributed in a solid angle of 4 pi multiplied by the solid angle of this conical zone, which is 2 pi 1 minus cos theta. So if we substitute it here, flux through the lateral surface we can write as q by epsilon naught minus q by 2 epsilon naught 1 minus cos theta is h by root of h square plus r square. So on simplifying, we are getting the flux through the lateral surface is q by 2 epsilon naught 1 plus h by root of h square plus r square. That is the result of the electric flux from the point charge plus q through the lateral surface of this vessel which is coming out. Now, in continuation, we can discuss some more such cases in which even if the shape of vessel changes, it won't affect the total electric flux coming out. Let's continue the same on the next sheet. Now, in continuation, if we discuss a situation in which we are given with a hemispherical cup and at the center of which we have placed a charge plus q. And say we wish to find out the electric flux coming out from the hemispherical region of this cup, then we can directly state as the charge is placed at center, 50% of the flux originated by the charge will come out from this hemispherical region of this cup. So directly you can say the flux which is coming out from the hemispherical region will be q by 2 epsilon naught, because the total flux originated by the charge is q by epsilon naught. Similarly, if the shape is not exactly hemisphere, if it is given like this, there is a distorted shape container which is having its circumference circular, and at the center of which we have placed a charge plus q, and say we are required to find out the total flux which will come out from the surface of this vessel or this container which is placed in the situation we can see here. Then also we can see as the charge is placed in the plane of its mouth, so we can say in this situation 50% of the flux originated by the charge will be going in the lower region and remaining 50% is passing out or coming through the surface of this container. So the total flux coming out from this container surface will be Q by 2 epsilon naught. So similar to this, we can discuss some situations like, say, if we are given with a cube, which is a uniform homogeneous cube, and at the center of this cube, we have placed the charge plus Q, and say we are required to find the amount of flux which is coming out from one face of the cube. Then we can say as the charge is placed at the center, all six faces of the cube are symmetric with respect to this charge. So from any of the face, the flux which will come out will be Q by 6 epsilon naught, because total flux is Q by epsilon naught. Similar to this, we can discuss many situations like, say, if we are given with a pyramid and at the center of pyramid base, if we place a charge plus Q and we are required to find from any of the phase what will be the amount of magnetic flux which is coming out, then here also we can say if it is placed at the center from the upper three phases, the total flux which will be coming out is Q by 2 epsilon naught, because 50% flux of this charge will be going below the base of this hemisphere, and out of remaining 50%, one third will come out from one phase. So from one phase, the flux which is coming out will be Q by 2 epsilon naught by 3, that will be again Q by 6 epsilon naught. So this is quite a logical way to calculate the electric flux from a point charge through a given symmetric distribution, and easily we can manage such kind of situation in various numerical problems.